Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope that you're having a great week so far. I am getting ready to go into my spring break, so I am super excited. But I wanted to go ahead and film a tutorial on my channel because I have not filmed a tutorial in so long. And also, I wanted to give you guys my thoughts in kind of a voiceover type way on the new Natural Love palette. Can you guys see that? The new Natural Love palette by Too Faced. It's got all of these like really pretty natural colors. I give you my thoughts in the voiceover, but I don't know. I'm kind of in between on this palette, guys. I'm gonna have to play with it for a little bit more, see how I really feel about it. Some of the shadows were really chalky, some were really unblendable. The other ones were really great to work with. So the ones that I did use, I kind of struggled with a little bit, but then there were some shimmer shades that were really good. The other thing I wasn't super fond of was the fact that there's not a lot of mattes. I mean, you only get like 4 or 5 mattes and the rest are like shimmers or satins or glitters. So I'm gonna go ahead and insert some pictures of this palette. I'm sure you guys have already seen it. I'm sure you've done your research. I'm sure you've watched a million other videos on it and reviews, but I just wanted to go ahead and give you my 2 cents and incorporate it into a demo because I don't get to do that a whole lot. So, you know, this video is kind of a jack of all trades. It has a lot of different products that I have never used before, some that I've picked up again and really loved. So if you guys are interested, then please make sure to keep watching. I did just want to go ahead and remind you, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below if you are new to my channel, and also leave me a comment if you're new so that I know you are and I can say, hey, how are you? Welcome to my channel. If you are already a subscriber, thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate you coming back and kind of hanging with me throughout this journey. It has been so fun and I'm so blessed. I'm hoping to do a giveaway on my channel soon. I hit 150 subscribers and that is a huge milestone for me. So please stay tuned and look out for that giveaway coming up, possibly when I hit 200 subscribers. I think that's all I've got, guys. So if you're interested in seeing me use this Too Faced Natural Love palette and some of these new ColourPop eyeshadows and you want to hear my thoughts and some things that I think about them, then please go ahead and just keep watching. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope that you're doing amazing. So I'm going to start out my tutorial today by using the Tarte Maracuja Oil. This was on sale for half off during 21 Days of Beauty, and I'm just using it as a moisturizer today because it is helping me currently with my breakouts and some redness. Now I'm going in with my BH Cosmetics eye primer. This is a dupe for MAC Painterly Paint Pot, and I really like it for setting eyeshadows for long periods of time. I was really into the Pure eye primer for a while, but not recently. I'm just going in with a Koki concealer brush. You can find these brushes at Walmart for a really decent price. I'm going in and just spreading that eye primer all over my eyes. Today I chose to do my eyes first because I felt like doing my face first just kind of get some fallout when I do use shadows that have more of a like chalky powdery consistency. And as you guys can see, the star of the show is the new Too Faced Natural Love palette. I'm going in to try this today because I wanted to give you my tried and true thoughts on it. So that's what I'm going to be doing. Just showing you the shades here, really pretty summer colors, really pretty natural colors, kind of colors I tend to go for a lot. So I am going in with this kind of bone shade. This is the color Heaven, and I'm just going in with a flat shader brush. I wanted to go ahead and lay this down on my eyelid first before I went in with any shades for transition or crease because I wanted to have a nice even canvas. Alrighty guys, so here I'm just finishing up blending out that lid shade, going in with Spotlight and Honey Butter. These are two of my very, very favorite shades in the palette. And here I'm just using a crease brush. Any crease brush will do that's a bit dense so that you can really get the color onto your eyelid. You're going to just see me blend back and forth and black and forth, back and forth until I build up the intensity that I really love.
Alright guys, so as you can tell here, I did go ahead and finish one of my eyes. My camera was dying, so I just decided to do that off camera. Here I'm going to go ahead and go in with the color Nudie, and I'm going to go in with a pointed shader brush just because I really want to define my eye a little bit more. And I wanted to use this really pretty, like, it's a very cool tone brown, but I thought that it would add a nice dimension to my eye before I go in with a little bit of a darker color in the outer V area. I really like this shade. It's different. I don't normally wear cool tone shades, but kind of after I put everything together, it grew on me. I didn't really like this look to begin with. I wasn't really loving the shadows. They were really hard to work with. So, all right, now I'm going in with the color Makeup and Chill, and I'm using, again, a really defined outer V brush. It's a really thin, pointed crease brush. This is normally what I use for my outer V because I really like the intensity that it gives and the definition that it gives. I really do like the fact that I always go in with an outer V shade just because I find that when I do that, my eye gets a lot of dimension that it normally doesn't have when I don't do that outer V to give it a little bit more of just like a pop. I find that when I put that outer V shade and put it in kind of a cat eye formation, the look just really is beautiful, and it's one of my favorite things to do when I'm applying my eyeshadow. So a good thing about not doing your face first before your eyeshadow is that if ever you feel like your eyeshadow isn't clean enough, you can always go in with a makeup wipe like I'm doing here just to clean it up and make sure that it's nice and concise and it doesn't look messy. Alrighty, so now time for the fun part. I am going in with Hot and Bothered and a very flat shader brush. I believe this one is by Morphe. I'm just spraying my brush with Fix Plus so that I can get that eyeshadow a little bit more intense on the lid. I really wanted that orange red kind of undertones to pop on my eye just so you could really see that eyeshadow through my lashes and through my winged liner that I'm going to do on my eye in just a bit. Now I'm using some of the new ColourPop shadows. These are really good, you guys. I was really excited to get these, and I'm going in with my flat shader brush. This one is really, really, really tiny. I don't have a name on this shadow because the sticker fell off, unfortunately, when they came to me, but any like really pretty pink champagne color will work for this look. I just wanted to give it a little bit more of a pop. And you're going to see me here blending together, of course, because that's one of the most important things to do when you're applying makeup, is making sure that all of your shadows are blended nicely together and that they look beautiful and that they look even. Alright guys, so going in with some liner now, I'm just taking my Stila Stay All Day liner so that I can get my waterline and my tight line really dark so that when I go to apply my winged liner and my eyelashes, everything blends really nicely together. I think actually I'm just going to do my tight lining right here, and then we're going to work on the under eye, the waterline here in just a bit. Okay, so now I'm going to go in for my wing liner. I'm using a super slim eyeliner. This I think is like a marker liner, so it's a skinny tip eyeliner by Wet n Wild, and this works really, really good for wing liner. I'm always scared to like do the second eye because I'm afraid that I'm gonna mess it up royally and like have to do it over and over and over again. Another good thing about not doing your foundation first is that if ever you mess up on your wing liner, then you can go back in and kind of redo it after you take it off with the makeup wipe and you don't mess up your foundation. Just a handy tip for you guys out there who do wing liner or who are practicing trying to get the hang of it. Alright, as always, my very favorite lashes, the Ardell 113s. These are the Glamour 113s though, guys, not the Wispy 113s. They are very different. The 113 Glamours have really pretty, like, corner, like, cat eye on the outer corner, whereas the Wispies just are, like, straight across but really full and fluffy. These have that really pretty cat eye edge, or outer corner I guess I should say, that just give me life. Like, these lashes give me everything that I am. I love them. They're beautiful. Don't ask me why. Hey guys, time for primer. Going in with my Benefit Porefessional and my Becca Backlight Primer. These are my two favorite primers at the moment. They do very different things, but I love them both equally. So I'm going to go in with the Porefessional on just my cheeks and kind of my T-zone where I have the larger pores. I really want to massage that into my skin just to make sure that those pores are filled, and then taking some of that Becca Backlight Primer and spreading it all over my face. This stuff smells so good, like coconuts. I use this as a moisturizer essentially, and then just to give me a little bit of that really pretty luminosity. Going in with my Bye Bye Redness, and again that same Cokie concealer brush, I'm going to use this to help me with my discoloration, where my birthmark is, on my cheeks, my nose, my chin, and a little bit in between kind of my nose and my upper lip. I really want to make sure I cover all of that redness to give me a nice even canvas. And then I'm going in to just kind of blend this out with both the concealer brush and a beauty blender or a beauty sponge. Now I'm going in with this Anastasia Yeah, this is the foundation stick. I barely tried this for the first time, you guys. This is in the color beige. I'm not sure how I feel about it yet. It's not super full coverage, but it's definitely buildable, and I'm trying it out. I really like it. It is exactly my color. I think that it's a beautiful finish. It's a very satin-based finish, but I'm going to have to try this for a little while longer because I'm not sure how I feel about it. I tried blending this with both a beauty sponge and with another Koki brush. The foundation brush, I believe. It's a Duke for Tarte, you guys. I love that brush. I'm really, really loving it right now. And then I wanted to first try to see if this would do better with spraying my face with Fix Plus and then kind of spraying the Beauty Blender, and it did. I've heard other people do that as well to kind of help with making sure that it blends out evenly. I do like this finish, like I said, but my favorite stick foundation is the Makeup Forever, and this definitely is not like the Makeup Forever. So there's that brush I was mentioning. Like I said, I do like the finish. I think it's pretty. All right, going into conceal now, I'm going to use the NARS New Concealer. This is that full coverage concealer that I use in my T-zone. So I'm going to use this on, again, that same concealer brush and just kind of going in, laying it down, and then blending it in with the beauty sponge. I do like this concealer for my T-zone because it is full coverage and it does kind of cover a little bit more of that birthmark that the Bye Bye Redness doesn't get. And then just going in, making sure that I'm blending all of that out first with a concealer brush and then going in with that beauty splendor. And then after that, I'm going to use my Tarte Shape Tape, which I absolutely love and adore. That's in the color Fair. And I also use that at first to kind of blend out with a concealer brush. And then I go in with a beauty sponge. And I like to blend that out in both ways. And then after that, I even it out by using a foundation brush just to kind of make sure that all of the lines are evenly spaced and that there is no like discoloration or no, you know, brightening in one area, not in the other area. I really like to blend out my base, or I guess my foundation, my concealer, all of that stuff before I go in and put on my powder, because after that it's a lot harder. I'm just being really, really careful because I want to make sure that I don't mess up my wing liner. I worked so hard on it, so I'm just making sure that I don't blend that into the concealer. And again, you'll kind of see me work back and forth and back and forth here with the sponge, the brush, going kind of back and forth using both of those tools just to make sure that I have all of my foundation and my concealer evenly spaced. Now I'm going in, or evenly spaced, evenly blended. I'm going in with the Kat Von D setting powder. This is specifically for your entire face, but I chose to use it for under my eyes because I absolutely love this as a setting powder. And then I'm using the Morphe setting brush specifically to lay down that powder. I'm going in under my eyes, my T-zone area, a little bit on my nose, a little bit on my chin, because I really want to make sure that I set the spaces or the spots on my face that have a little bit more creasing. Now going in with my MSF09 in the color Caramel. This is the NYX foundation stick. I use this to contour my face when I do cream contouring. It is the best stick ever. I did try the Anastasia one in the same exact color, but I feel like this is a little bit better for me. Going in with a e.l.f. brush. This is specific to contouring. I love the angle of this brush because it really does get into those finer spaces that are sometimes harder to blend out with another tool. Alright guys, now I'm going to go ahead and set the rest of my face with another Morphe Big Huge Powder Brush and the CoverGirl Stay All Day Powder. This is one of my favorite combinations right now for setting my face. It mattifies, it stays put, it's wonderful. So I'm just going in, making sure I get my neck, making sure I get my forehead, making sure I get my cheeks, and everywhere that I didn't get with that original Kat Von D setting powder. And then I just kind of go in and add that setting powder once more underneath my eyes to give it a little bit more brightening that I may have wiped away with the regular powder. Now I'm going to go ahead and go in and do some under eye work just to show you guys what I did on my other eye. Using the Stay All Day Liner once more, going into my waterline, making sure that I give my eye a little bit more dimension and definition. And then I'm going to make sure that I go into my under eye with the same colors as I did my top. This is again Makeup and Chill and Honey Butter, going in with a crease brush and a blended outer V brush, a blending outer V brush to go ahead and do my under eye. Make sure that it really matches nicely with the with my eyelid, and I really wanted to make sure that I diffused the colors on my lower lash line, but that I also made them pop. So that's why I kind of chose the darker color first, which is Makeup and Chill, and then I chose Honey Butter to kind of diffuse that under eye, just to make it look really nice and cohesive with my upper eyelid. Alright guys, so now I'm going to play with my inner corner a little bit. I am going to mix Kitty Cat with a little bit of that wider shade. I don't really use it a whole lot, that ice, the ice highlight in there, but I really do like Kitty Cat. So I'm going in and just making sure that I'm blending those two colors together with a really defined pencil brush, and then just blending it out in my lower lash line and my upper lash line, taking a beauty sponge and making sure that I don't get the inner corner too far underneath my eye so that it looks like I have, you know, snowflakes on my eyeballs or something. I just really wanted to give my inner corner a little bit more definition. Alright, so now I get to play with some new blushes and new highlights. This is the color Captivating by Tarte, and just a Wet n Wild. I can use a contour brush, but I used it for blush. I got this from the 21 Days of Beauty sale, and I really wanted to try it out. So again, this is Captivating by Tarte. I really do like this blush. It is gorgeous. And then I'm just using a beauty blender, which this is a technique I really like to do, actually. I blend in my blush to the rest of my face with that beauty blender. Going in with a Tarte highlighter now. This is in the color Stunner, and I'm using the Anastasia highlighting brush. I really love this highlight, you guys. It is so beautiful. I was gonna get exposed, and then I was like, I don't know, I have a lot of gold highlighters, so I went with Stunner. Oh, so beautiful. And again, I picked this up from the 21 Days of Beauty sale at Ulta, and I'm so glad I did. So you guys are just gonna see me here working the highlighter into my skin a couple of times, going back and forth with that Anastasia highlighting brush, just to make sure that I have my face evenly highlighted. You know me, I have to be blinding. You have to be able to see me from Mars, so I really love to go in there with my highlight. And again, just using that same technique, taking the beauty blender. Sometimes I spray my beauty blender or my face with Fix Plus first, just to give me a little bit more of a wetness first before I go in and dampen it or kind of piece it down or place it down with that beauty sponge. And then just going in and making sure everything is blended together. Now I'm going to go ahead and use my lipstick. This is a new one by Too Faced. This is in the color Suck It. And that's about it. Thanks so much for joining me, guys. Hope you guys have a great day, and hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. See you soon. Bye. Totally forgot to mention to you guys that I did purchase the new Rose Gold Lip Topper by Jouer Cosmetics, and it is absolutely stunning. I put that on top of the color Suck It by Too Faced, the Melted Matte. It just went in, oh my god, you guys, it glides on perfectly. It goes wonderful over any color that you use, a nude, a berry, whatever you choose. It is just absolutely gorgeous. So that's it, guys. Anyway, just wanted to tell you that little side note. If you haven't purchased that Jouer Lip Topper, you guys need to get your hands on it. Have a good night, guys. See y'all soon. Alright guys, so this is the final look. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that you learned something or appreciated some of my thoughts on some of these palettes and some of the other products that I used. The Tarte blushes, the highlighter, the lip product that's new by Too Faced. I really do love the color. I think that it's a beautiful like spring summer color. I may have to go get my hands on a couple more of these just because the colors are so pretty. If you are interested in another tutorial like this where I review new products, or you just kind of want to see another tutorial, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you know when I upload videos, which is about 2 to 3 times a week. I really appreciate you guys being subscribers, and remember, don't ever let anybody tell you that you have to be something that you don't want to be. Mwah! Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in my next video. Take care.